Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Cuphead. Stay on your guard, intrepid cups. Fetching those ingredients will be a test of wit and wills. I bet. Considering all the last bosses and whatnot I've fought. But remember, like any good bake, heart and soul is the secret ingredient. I'll keep that in mind. Thank you for the advice. You got anything else to say, buddy? Worry not, I'll keep perfecting this recipe while you're out and about. That's cool. Don't you need the ingredients first? I just know you'll put yourself fully into bringing the Wonder Tart to life. Yeah, it does sound quite nice, doesn't it? Sounds really nice. The fabled ingredients await, friends. Yeah, I'll get to them in, man. I just want to see if you got any more dialogue. Now where do I put the salt? You are a salt shaker, is it in your head? Just a guess? I don't know. One more thing, chaps. Remember to equip that nifty cookie charm in the menu if you want to battle as Miss Chalice. I'll keep that in mind, but we'll only be playing as Miss Chalice a few times because, truth be told, I have not mastered her play style yet. But here's the actual cookie. You can play as Miss Chalice. So, this is why a lot of people like to start with the DLC first so they can get Miss Chalice right away, because some people really like playing as Miss Chalice. And don't get me wrong, I've seen speedrunners, you know, that mastered the game with Miss Chalice do really good. But me, I have not mastered Miss Chalice yet, so we're not going to be seeing a whole lot of her. But I will say this, if you're looking to play through this game for the first time, you may want to consider Miss Chalice, because she does have a double jump, which can be useful. The parry dash and dodge roll can also be nice, so I wonder if she's a Dead Rising fan. As you play Dead Rising, just saw the dodge roll that Frank West and Chuck Green do, and it's like, I want to do that. I want to dodge roll through everything. But real quick, what happens if Miss Chalice chooses to join the devil? Because again, she is playable in the main campaign, so let's see what happens if I'm playing as her and side with the devil. I'm sure nothing new is going to happen, but let's find out, right? Well, there's your answer. A horrifying cutscene becomes that much more horrifying. So I just want to get that done real quick, but, anyways, let's talk to the paperboy now that I've beaten the main campaign.
Extra, extra, Chef Saltbaker, we're best baker in all the lands. Oh, you them cups what took out the devil, ain't ya?
Yes, we are.
This house tough, but you sent that in packing, you got suitcases to spare.
And if he didn't already give me the 3 coins, he would give me the 3 coins here, but, I do know the dialogue changes a bit, but I don't know how. But anyways, what's this? A ladder? Let's check it out. The King's Leap? Okay, let's check it out.
The King of Games greets you with pomp and much ado. To thine own gameplay true, or thus thou fate shall rule.
God, I love this theme. This is so awesome, I love it. Hail, ye cups, I bid thee welcome to my floating palace. Nice to meet ya. I am the one true king, the king of games. So I guess King Dice was a knockoff then. From afar, I have seen you battle with Seal and Ablom. I've never even heard that word before. Is that even a real word? I'm curious now. May it's an old word that nobody uses anymore. And lo, I grant thee a place in my royal tourney. Really? That sounds cool. What kind of royal tourney? In these bouts, your weapons and charms shan't be of use. What? I don't get any weapons or charms? How's that work? You'll have to find different means to best my champions. Okay. from victory's riches. Now into the fray with haste. Okay. But first I gotta change to Miss Joust. Forsmuth, my first champion awaits. Or Forsooth, how it's pronounced. Seriously, he uses a lot of old words that I imagine aren't used anymore.
A great slam and then some. And begin!
So, for the King's Leap, I'm going to be using Miss Chalice for the most part, but I will be using Cuphead in one particular bout, so yeah. This is how Miss Chalice works. She does the parry dash, she has the double jump, so she's pretty good for most of these bosses, but I'm just going to be honest, not a fan of the King's Leap. Not at all. If I'm honest, I would have much preferred some more running gun levels, but that's just me. So, yeah. And those pawns, they look easy, but trust me, they can be really annoying depending on the RNG, so I really don't like those pawns. With this valiant victory, I bestow riches onto thee. Why, thank you. And now away with ye. Okay. Anyways, that's that. And, yeah. I did have to cut out me going back to re-equip the cookie and whatnot. Because, yeah, I tried with Cuphead, and trust me, it's really annoying. That one's really annoying with Cuphead. But anyways, Glumstone the Giant and Gnome Way Out.
Good day for us. Well, you're up.
Well, you're a big giant, aren't you? So here's the first of, six new bosses. If my math's remembering right, I'm pretty sure it's six, because, yeah, you just fight the six bosses, and then you make the Wonder Tart. There's definitely not a secret boss. There's definitely not a surprise at the end. Nope, none of that. But, this boss in particular, I don't think he's too bad, if I'm honest. Honestly, the number one problem with Glumstone is just the RNG, especially in the opening here. Because, those pillars go up and down at random. There's one attack you didn't get to show off, but sometimes you'll hold up a geese crossing sign and, blow a whistle, or his nose will turn into a whistle and a bunch of geese will float across the screen. And the problem with that is, if the platform drops or raises up at the wrong time, you're going to get hit by the geese, and it really sucks, so that part's just really annoying. If I'm honest, I'm not a fan of this part either. That ball they're juggling around can be really hard to dodge, and you may notice those puppets look a lot like King Dice and the Devil, don't they? Nice little callback, I guess, but yeah, and the gnomes, screw the gnomes, seriously, they just keep jumping out of his ripped off beard and jumping around. It's really annoying. I don't really care for that section, but what? Oh crap, I'm dead. Okay, no I'm not. I have no idea what that is, but yeah, we're in the giant's stomach now, and here you really want Crackshot, in my opinion. For this whole boss, I find Crackshot works best, personally. Some people might like Twist Up too, but me personally, I'm Crackshot all the way. So whenever one of those skeleton tongues come out, you want to parry the tongue so the platforms will reset and just keep shooting away at whatever the heck that thing is, and eventually you'll be knocked out. So, yep, that's Glumstone the Giant. I don't think he's that bad. He's definitely not my favorite of the DLC, but he's still pretty cool. I like him. Yep, so that's that. Unfortunately, I don't have the HP bonus because I did take a hit there before I got my 3 HP back with the ring, so yeah. Still got an A-minus though, so I'll take it. And, yep. So now we got the Gnome Berries. Fantastic. Alright, so now we come down here and time to go to the King's Leap once again. And time to take on the one boss that I'll be doing with Cuphead, not Miss Chalice. Prithee, proceed to the next battle. Alas, mind thee well, weapons and charms have nary an effect. Again, what is with this guy's weird talking? I don't get it.
Good day for us. Well, it's on.
So yeah, in case you haven't guessed yet, they're all chess pieces. So now we have the knight, and the knight, in my opinion, is definitely a little more fun than the pawns, in my opinion. But he can be a little bit annoying because you have to be close to him in order for him to attack. Like you saw him doing the get over here animation earlier. He will only do that if you're too far away. So yeah, you basically gotta stay close to this guy, but don't get too close that you get hit by his attacks and whatnot. And I have seen some people that can do this with Miss Chalice and like wreck this guy really quick. I am not one of those people. I have to take it nice and slow with Cuphead or Mugman, personally. So, yeah, I've tried this with Miss Chalice, and I just find it harder, personally. Maybe I'm missing something. I don't know. Maybe I'm just inexperienced with Miss Chalice. I don't know. That's probably the most likely thing. Yeah, he's... Whenever you're too far away, he'll do that get over here, then you gotta get over there to get him to do stuff again. So, yeah. I used to find this guy really annoying when I first fought him because I didn't understand. I was like, why do you keep doing the get over here thing? I don't want to get over there. I know you're just going to launch an attack on me, but once I figured out, this guy actually became really fun, and I don't know if he's my favorite. It's either him or the queen who's last, because they're both really fun in my opinion. In my opinion, they're the only two really fun bosses here, because spoiler alert, I hate the next two. Oh yeah, I hate them both. Big time. But we'll talk about them when we get to them. So, apologies, this is going kind of slow, but that's just the way this boss is. It's meant to be very slow paced. Just kind of jump on his helmet whenever you get the chance. But the only problem is you don't get a lot of chances because, like that upward swipe he does, I never hit him. Never even attempt to hit him there because it's so quick. I only try it when he does the dash or when he does the big swipe. You can tell he's going to do the big swipe because his helmet will reveal his eyes, so let's see those pretty eyes. Nope. Okay, dash, that's fine. Alright, come on, show us your pretty eyes, horsey. No, not that one. Come on, other one. There it is, so yeah. That's why I know he'll be stunned a few seconds longer and get at least one or two hits in. Sometimes I can get three, but I wasn't feeling too risky this playthrough, so yeah. But there we go, that's the night. Pretty fun boss, if I say so myself, but again, I'm not a big fan of the King's Leap. I really don't like the idea of taking away my weapons, personally. With this valiant victory, I bestow riches onto thee. Thank you again. And now away with ye. And yeah, that's how you get all the coins. So yeah. Next up is Mortimer Freeze and Snow Colt Scuffle.
A brawl is surely brewing. It's on!
Let me tell you now, guys, I used to really hate this guy, like, really freaking hate him. He was so ridiculously hard, in my opinion. You know, all three phases were just really difficult, in my opinion, but now, eh, it's alright. I don't love this guy, per se. He's definitely not one of my, you know, most beloved bosses in the entire game, but, he's not bad. I'll definitely take him over Dr. Call and his stupid robot any day, that's for sure, but that's not saying a lot. So this phase is kind of crazy, because I turned into a giant snow monster. And the one word of advice I gotta give, watch his pattern, because I said, oh, there he does a roll. But sometimes he'll do a little jump, and then he'll do a jump roll instead, so you gotta watch out for that. Word of advice for the fridge section when he shoots those ice cubes. If you just stay in the right spot, I find they'll always land in the same place every time. That's what I'm talking about. Sometimes he'll do a leap jump like that. But with the ice cubes, I find there's really no RNG. They always seem to land in the same place every time. So all you really gotta do is find the right place to stand, and you'll be fine. Those blades can be kind of hard to avoid, in my opinion. But I fought this guy so many times now that it's not so bad. This final phase, though, can be a bit annoying. That eyeball is really hard to dodge, in my opinion. Not impossibly hard, but it can be a little tricky. Just because I always forget when the lasers are going to shoot. And those buckets can be kind of a pain, too. He does have one other attack. I don't know if he actually does it or not, though. I might destroy him before he does it. Yeah, there it is. The ice cream cones, or the ice creams there. How did I not get hit there? I am surprised, but whatever. I'll take it. So, yeah, those can be kind of hard to dodge, too. But basically, if I can just offer one more advice for Mortimer Freeze, just keep practicing dodging. And once you get used to that, you'll be no problem. You really gotta master dodging before anything else, so... Don't be surprised if he kills you quite a few times your first try, because he certainly killed me a lot of times my first try, no doubt about that. Ugh. But, yeah, I don't think he's, like, bad now, and we got the icy sugar cubes. Cool. Still, not one of my personal favorites in the whole game, though. If we're talking the whole game as a whole, no, I still prefer Grim Matchstick. I still prefer, Briny Beard, all them. And we'll come back to this grave and that ghost later, because time to take on King's Leap again. Hello. Eid, a new challenger lies just beyond that door. And now we come to probably my least favorite or second least favorite in the whole game.
This match will get red hot. And begin!
I don't play chess, so I don't remember what this guy's called, the root rook or whatever. But I'm just gonna say it like it is. I hate this boss with a burning passion. Like, seriously. This guy is so annoying for me. Like, seriously. Like, all these bells and whatnot you got dodged, got hit all the candles before he can hit his head. I mean, with Miss Chalice, it's certainly easier, but again, I haven't mastered Miss Chalice yet, so personally, I just find this really, really annoying. And the first time playing, I didn't try Miss Chalice. I just went with Cuphead and Mugman, and you know, it went okay. I eventually got after like 20, 30, 50 tries, something like that. And with Miss Chalice, again, it's certainly easier, but at the same time, I just don't find it that fun, that satisfying, if I'm honest. I don't like this boss, what can I say? The next one is even worse, in my opinion, so, look forward to that. But yeah, honestly, how'd I get hit there? I don't like the King's Leap, mainly because of this guy and the next guy. The rest are okay, but no, screw that guy. I know a lot of people like that guy, but I hate him. With this valiant victory, I bestow riches onto thee. So, yeah, I didn't get to talk about much, but trust me, I really don't like him. I really, really hate him. But, anyways, folks, that's going to do it for me. So, thank you all for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Later.